Hello kids, I, Ms. Benira Fernandez, your English teacher, would like to introduce to you to a new topic, kinds of sentences. As you heard, we have already learned about sentences in the last grade. Now, I will tell you more about sentences and its different kinds. For this, let's go through the video. What is a sentence? As you all know, a sentence is a group of words which needs or which must make a complete sense in those set of words or which needs to give some meaning to your group of words. There are four types of sentences. First one is declarative, second one is imperative, third one interrogative, and the fourth one exclamatory. Now let's go into details of all these words and see what each one means when it comes to their own sentence. The first, declarative sentence. A declarative sentence is a sentence which makes a statement or gives some information about it, and it always ends with a full stop. See the four examples. First example, there is a chemical factory nearby. We know that there is some factory nearby and the details added a chemical factory. Second one, I won a quiz contest. I is the subject and the subject has won a contest which is of quiz. Third is the sky is blue. All these sentences end with a full stop. The second one, imperative sentences. An imperative sentence is a sentence which gives a command or makes a request or even a wish. It mostly ends with a full stop, but at times it ends with an exclamation mark also. Let's look at these examples. Please be quiet, the baby is sleeping. Now, we know this is a request. Why? Because there is a word please in that. Second one, kindly pass the book. In this, we even know that this is also a request because of the word used, kindly. Do not go there. Do not go there is a command and it can be given to a set of people or an individual. Next, the interrogative sentences. Now, interrogative sentences in itself is a type of sentence which makes a question or which asks a question, and it will always end with a question mark. Let's look at this example. How have you read the newspaper? Where are you going? Why are you running so fast? Now, you can see that there is a question in each statement. How do we know that there is a question? We have learned the WH questions last year. And in that, we know the certain words used for WH questions. So, where, why, when are related to questions. And some other exceptions are have, can, could. These also end into a asks as a question. The last, the fourth one. What we have is exclamatory sentence. What is an exclamation? An exclamation expresses our feelings. An exclamatory sentence will always express our happiness, anger, fear, gust, or shocked feeling. It always ends with a exclamation mark. For example, what an impossible task that is. You know that the task cannot be completed. And that's why you're using a strong feeling saying, I can't do the task. It's nearly impossible for me. The second one, hooray, we won the match. Now, hooray in itself, you all know that it's a exclamation sentence. I am angry. Anger is also another type of a strong feeling which you're telling another person that you're angry. Now that you have learned the four different types of sentences, I have a small activity for you. The name of the activity is Silly Sentence Building Activity. Now what you need to do is you need to create four types of sentences. Two similar with question, one with exclamation, and one with a full stop. There are words given in the table. You need to mix and match and create a meaningful sentence. You can do this activity in your home rough note and bring it to school on the first day of opening. Thanks a lot for watching the video. Hope to see you soon.